My fucking Corey Danger.
Okay, I sees you. Hey, what up? It's your boy, Corey Danger here, and I'm doing this little video because I was on my Twitter feed. One of my friends posted this thread, Dining in Restaurants 101. If you're watching, I hope you don't mind if I use this or paraphrase this for a video, because I kinda agree with pretty much all he has to say. A little backstory, I am a server currently. My friend is also a server, and I believe he was also a manager of a restaurant. But then he stepped down because of, I guess, conflicts of issues of maybe timing management, or he wanted to make more money as a server. Who knows? I don't really know the reasons, but he recently posted this on his Twitter. First, it starts off with, since a lot of y'all don't know how to act, dining in restaurants 101. So this is for you who go into restaurants. You know who you are. Take heed. Take some notes. Listen. Open your eyes and shut your mouth, because you're about to get a little truth bomb in your mind. Number one, it says, stop flagging just any server down. Servers have their own section and have their own flow with their steps of service. Your server's role is to take care of you, so they will do so. Now, what he's trying to say is, as a server, you're always busy, right? On busy days, it could be hectic. You could be in the weeds. You could be stressing the F out. You have more than one table, so obviously if one table asks you for something, you're gonna boom, go get it. But while you're gone, another table might want something, and they're gonna flag down whoever passes by. Most guests assume that every server is their server. A lot of them don't know that there's sections. Every server has a specific section that they're supposed to watch over, which he goes on to explain in the rest of the next part of the thread, which is most servers should be on top of their table according to their steps of service, which is true. He does have a caveat saying, now I completely understand if you feel neglected as a guest, your server doesn't check you up, they don't give you refills, then you can bring this up to management if you're dissatisfied in service. So his explanation as to why this you shouldn't flag down any server, time is everything, which is true. In service, I gave this answer to my current manager who is hiring, is like, what do you feel is the most important thing about being a server? And I said, timing. You know, everything is about timing. When the guest comes in, it has to be meet with the host in a timely manner, letting them know how long it's gonna take if there's a wait, and trying to get them seated as quickly as possible, and get your server to approach them as quickly as possible, get their drinks as quickly as possible, and get their order as quickly as possible, and get all their needs met as quickly as possible. So that's what timing is. Timing is everything to make your guest as happy as possible. So, he says, so if flagging other servers down for one thing at a time, not only that ruins the flow of everything, but delays service to other tables. The amount of trips your server needs to take from your table and back is so inconvenient to everyone. So if your server asks if they can get anything else, be considerate enough to let them know so they can deliver it all at once. People are so impatient, I swear, that they feel like they will die if they don't get extra sauce in 2 seconds. This is true. Like, some people won't even eat without sauce. Like, they want the sauce right now, and you don't want to get lost in the sauce. So yeah, when you're flagging down another server who probably has something else in their mind that they have to get, now they gotta stack that on top of whatever it is they're trying to get. So you're just ruining everyone, because that server now has to go find the other server who's like, where is they? I don't know where they are. Oh my god, I gotta tell them. Oh fuck, I forgot about ranch dressing and blah 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 blah. So you're messing up the whole thing, right? If you don't ask, like, when your specific server asks, can I get you anything else? Which they usually do either after they drop off the food, right? Or whenever they're taking your order, they're always asking. They're waiting for you to say something. If you need something, say something when they're there. Don't wait till they're gone, right? That's just inconvenient to both parties, because now you're waiting for them, and then they have to put in extra effort to go find whatever it is you want. This one also, some respect for the servers who are catering to your every needs would be nice. When your server greets you, especially if it's warm and friendly, the least you can do is look up and listen with eye contact. I've seen people with their face buried in their phone while the server is trying to take care of the order, even though they said they're ready to order. You realize that you're stalling your server just delays them from checking up on the other tables they may have. This is true. It also becomes very awkward, especially for me. It happens to me a lot. You either have guests that want their order right away, but they're talking to each other, or they're looking in their phone, or they're not even paying attention to you. I have approached tables like, "Hi, welcome to so-and-so, my name is this," and nobody's paying attention. They're just talking to each other, and I'm just standing there like, okay, should I walk away? Should I wait? And that's just gonna make you guys angry, because once you stop talking, you'll be like, where's our waiter? We've been waiting for 10 minutes, even though I came up to you, I introduced myself, you weren't paying attention. It's not my fault. I came up to you, but you guys were too busy talking about whatever it is you were talking about, or you're on your phone, or you know, you say you're ready, but you're not really, because I'm standing there for 5 minutes, pen and paper in my hand, just waiting for you to say something. At least be considerate. I came up to you, I'm making the effort, and you're just like not giving a damn. Allow the servers to explain the menu or anything that you need to be informed about, if you know they're out of anything or anything's not available, before rudely just interrupting them midway to tell them you want a glass of water. I haven't had that experience. I usually only tell them if we're out of something if they order something specifically, like, oh, I'm sorry, we're out of this. I don't go, just to let you guys know ahead of time, we're out, blah, 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 blah. Like, I don't want to waste each other's time, so usually I start off with, can I get your drink order first? Then, if they want to order anything, that's when I let them know if we're out of anything specifically. So, everyone's steps is different. The servers are not responsible for the prices or why the menu is the way it is. Examples, set portions, the price, if it's too expensive. So complaining for 10 minutes about it is really just inconvenient. If you have concerns, you can voice it out to management. Once again, I don't think I've had this problem yet. Because of where I work, it's not high class, it's not low class, it's just sort of in the middle, and prices are usually affordable. If it's someplace like a steakhouse or seafood like lobster, then I can understand why people might complain about prices. So it just depends on where you're at, what you're serving. Do not snap your fingers when trying to call your server from across the restaurant. Not only is it rude, but it is the most disrespectful shit you can ever do. This is true. Now, once again, it never happened to me, but it has happened to others of my fellow coworkers, and my fellow coworkers were pissed that someone would just snap their fingers. You're not a king. I mean, of course, we're there to serve you. Not like literally, but we're here to hand you your drinks, your food, take your order. We're not there on your every beck and whim, right? We're not, yes, your majesty, yes, your highness, allow me, sir, step on my back so you can step on, you know, your throne or whatever. We're not there for that, okay? So snapping your fingers, that's super disrespectful. Like, you don't want us to snap our fingers whenever we're there to take your order and you're not paying attention. Like, hey, I'm here, can I take your order? No, you wouldn't like that, and we wouldn't like that from you. Let's be all warm and courteous to each other and not snap. You get it. If you are in a hurry and expect the food out in 5 minutes, then go and eat at McDonald's, because every food has its proper temp to serve. Unless you want salmonella or some shit, then sure. But stop trying to rush food just because you're impatient. Yeah, there's nothing I can say. Like, food is an art. It takes time. You can't just rush it unless you're actually labeled fast food. So if you go in a restaurant that's not labeled fast food, don't expect everything to come out just because you're hungry, right? The more hungry you are, the food is not gonna come out the faster, okay? So especially when it's busy. If you're waiting, if there's a wait, then you're gonna have to fucking wait for the food, okay? So just get that in your mind. If you don't wanna end up with food poisoning, if you don't wanna end up sick, allow the food to cook at a proper temperature, at a proper time. And you gotta take into consideration that there's other people in the restaurants who's waiting for their order as well. So don't get mad, be patient. I know you're hangry, but we're gonna do the best that we can to get you happy. And he goes to explain, we understand you're hungry, but so is everyone else, especially if they were there before you. Be considerate. A well-done steak is not going to come out in 5 minutes. That's true. Well, if you want well-done, you got to be even more extra patient, okay? Don't ask for well-done and expect it right away. If you're dining as a large party, just know that your server is trying to do the best that they can. for all of you. Your server only has two hands and can only move as quick as your group allows them to. And if you plan on paying separately, let your server know ahead of time. This is true. I handle a lot of groups, especially when your section is upstairs. Because you're upstairs, it's usually you get seat the biggest parties because you have the biggest space. So I have to handle a lot of parties at a lot of times. So it does take time to go to each and every person to get what they want. And especially sometimes I even have to ask before, ahead of time, just to get mentally prepared. It's like, are you guys paying separately or together? If you're paying together, oh my god, you're the best group ever. If you're paying separate, I guess, but yeah. If servers and busters are trying to clean your table, refrain from handing them all your plates, unless it's far from their reach. Then you can lend a hand. They will bust what they are capable of carrying, so stacking plates on them while both arms are piled with plates is a dick move. This is true. You're picking up whatever you can, and you're about to leave, and then all of a sudden, the person is starting to hand you... hand you more, and you're like, I'll be right back. Let me just drop these off and I'll get the rest. Yeah, it is kind of a dick move. They might, you know, spill it or something. Lastly, if your server without a doubt busted ass just to make sure you enjoyed your dining experience and you made them go through hell with your thousands of requests, tip them. I mean, you don't have to. If you see that your server is busting the sweat, breathing a little hard, tried to get everything that they possibly can that you requested to you in a timely manner, give them something a little extra. I mean, they busted their ass for you. This doesn't apply to everybody, especially where I currently work, but some places do have it. They have a service charge in some places, but not everything goes to your server. Some servers get paid below minimum, so sometimes even a paycheck isn't enough for cost of living. Sometimes it's centralized, sometimes it's split by percentage, but don't assume just because there's a service charge that they deserve all the shit you put them through, especially on busy holidays. These servers would love to spend the holidays with their families just as much as everyone else dining in, so them sacrificing their time to tend to your rudeness is not how they want to spend the holidays. The end. Now for that last statement, some servers actually want to work on holidays because they know holidays is one of the most banking tip wise days that they can get. So some people request for holidays and some people don't. So you don't know which one you're gonna get. As a restaurant patron, you're there because you don't want to cook, right? You don't want to cook for the holidays, so you're there. They're there because either they're forced to, because it's part of their schedule, or they want to. You don't know, it's a flip of the coin, which server you're going to get. But most of the times, each server gives you the same kind of service that they give everyone else, to the best of their abilities. I've been to a previous restaurant where people see service charge, and they're like, oh, that's the tip, that's good enough. Now, while... So it does all depends on what the restaurant does, but my previous job that I worked at that did have service charge, 100% doesn't go to the server. A portion of that is taken out and divvied amongst bussers, bartender, and the back of the house. So even though your $100 check says a 10% service charge is 10 bucks, the whole $10 isn't going straight to the server. They're only getting a piece of that while everything else is given to everyone else. That's how they were doing it. Another job that I had, the service charge was pooled together, so they collected it. I don't understand how they did it like this, but the way they did it is for those 2 weeks, every service charge was put together, and then you got a percentage of that total service charge. You understand what I'm trying to say? The amount of tip you got highly depended on how much stuff you could sell. So you got, like, let's say for the week, 2 weeks, $1,000 was collected from service charge. So servers only got, I don't know, 10% of that split. Everyone got only 10% of $1,000. So it could be very little. So if you sold that $2,000, then your service charge gets more. I didn't really understand why it did that, but that's how they did it. And on top of that, you didn't get it that day. You get it with your paycheck. So whatever you made on your hours, and there would be this little portion on the bottom that said service charge, and it was like $100. Literally, for 2 weeks, that service charge, you only got $100 extra. So that's why I quit that place, because what the fuck, man? I'm working my ass off. There was 3 tiers in this job. Tier number one was service charge, which is everything was pulled together and it was divided amongst everybody. Front of the house and back of the house. Then there was credit card tips. You didn't get the whole credit card tips. That was divided amongst the front of the house. And then whatever cash tip was left that day, you get to keep. So out of all those three, only one of them is actually all yours to keep. That's if you get cash tip, mind you. Everything else is divvied amongst other people. Front of the house and everybody, front of the house and back of the house. That kind of sucked. So that's why I didn't want to stay in that job anymore, because I felt like I was working too much and not making enough. That's the video. This is running a little long, and I know I'm just gonna forget to edit it. It's gonna take me forever. But I just wanted to share with what my friend posted on Twitter. I'd agree with most, if not all, of what my friend posted. Like, if you're a server, I'm pretty sure you can understand. I'm pretty sure you have a lot of other tips that you can share. If you do, please leave a like, a comment, a subscription, whatever, what have you. If you're a patron, please just understand that we are there to try to make your eating experience, your dining experience, the best that we possibly can. But you also got to take into consideration that if you are walking the front door and they tell you that there's a 30 to 45 minute wait, well, it's not just because there's no tables, okay? So you got to expect that even the food is going to take a while to get to you, that your servers might take a little bit extra time to get to you because they're busy serving whoever's already there. Let's all be considerate to each other. Let's all be happy. Let's all just tip as much as possible to your server. Make their life a little bit more pleasant. And yeah, that's all I gotta say about that. So as always, guys, please like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you next time. Love, peace, and chicken grease. I got too much.